This is Vaseem, feeling euphoria to express my view on Indian constitutions, and I'd like to thank the entire team of English Form to organize weekly program on constitution. As we all know that after a long struggle of freedom movement, we got independence on 15 August 1947. But it was very difficult to lead such a vast nation, India. It was very big and highly populous. So there was a need of rule and regulations, law and order, that is constitution. But the big question mark was that, who will draft it? Who will write it? This was the big question mark for those who are the foremost leaders, foremost freedom fighters like Gandhi ji, Jawaharlal Nehru, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. They all were highly confused. So there was only one name which came in their mind, that is Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. They confronted, but very first he denied, as I studied anywhere. But he thought deeply at night that if I deny and chance is given to other, so how other will draft, there is no guarantee. So I must agree. So second day, when very first Jawaharlal Nehru and Gandhi ji came in the contact of Bhimrao Ambedkar Sahib, so he denied. But at night he deeply thought about the matter, and second day he agreed. Then one drafting committee was founded under guidance of Bhimrao Ambedkar, which contains 7 members. There was also one Muslim, Sadullah Sahib was there. And they studied round about the constitutions of 60 nations and adopted several things from the several countries, like parliamentary system from England, presidential system, the post of president, vice president, Supreme Court, like from America, and different things from the different countries. But the half part of Indian Constitution Act 1935 was also. So including these all, it took 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. Finally, it was completed on 26 November 1949. But finally, it was imposed on 26 and 1950. Since then, we got constitutional right. As sir mentioned, also very good point, that since implementation of this constitution, every Indian, whether they were male, female, they all got all sorts of rights, whether to cast vote or to survive, to get their bread and butter, job, everything in India. So this is the plus point in India which we have been enjoying. Rather, in France, as sir mentioned, that the revolt of France was in 1789, but in 1944 they were given right to cast vote. Guys, as when constitution was implemented, that very time there were 395 articles, 22 parts and 8 schedules. Still parts and schedules are there, but due to amendment facility in constitution, right now it is 448. Time to time there is also remedial, and amendment of constitution is also there by article 32 and article 368. So thus this constitution give us every sort of right. The main 6 fundamental rights, directive state of principles, and the 3 division of the government, like executive, legislative and judiciary. Parliament contains 3 parts, president, upper house, lower house, Lok Sabha, Raj Sabha. Everything which is written in constitutions give us right to survive, to have food, clothes, shelter, job, anywhere in India. And if we are unable to enjoy it, exercise it, then we can claim in High Court and Supreme Court for our fundamental rights. So this is the stability of Indian constitution, which was drafted by Bhimrao Ambedkar, the genius scholar of that very time. So this gives us right. to enjoy our life. So I must thank to Bhimrao.